I don't know what this opening clip is. I forgot to watch it, but let's find out together, shall we?
You lost half your brow.
You lost half your brow. Oh yeah. You feel that? You feel that? Come on, baby. Welcome to the Dynamite Gizmo Podcast, everyone. Episode 203. We're at 203 episodes in, my guy. How fun is that? How fun is it? I use that microphone for streaming now. Here's today's card. It's tradition around here to show you the card, but it's not tradition to show you what's on the card, but you find out anyway. Why? Because we'll talk about it. We'll talk about it. I'm trying something different with the lighting today. I don't know if it looks that different. It's a little bit kind of more dark, but there's like just enough light. I don't know. I'll see how it looks in the edit. I just tried it last second. I was like, this might be a nice little touch.
We interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
Just doing some editing and realizing how shitty this episode is. So, I've been doing some thinking, and I have a pretty good plan for what I want to do for a new format for the podcast. So I'm hoping from the next episode onward, it'll be much more crisp, clean, and it'll have some substance because I actually have a proper format that I want to do. So if you don't want to watch this episode, don't bother. But from next episode on, I think it's going to get better. Okay.
Huh? Do you like being touched, little boy?
Okay, guys.
Jackpot.
Yeah.
Dun, dun.
All right, we've got a lot of stuff planned today. No, we don't, because we never do. All right? This is off the cuff, off the skern, that, off the... What am I trying to say? Don't know. Don't ask. Don't ask, don't tell. Uh-oh, I should get these guys out in front, huh? Remember this? This is part of the decoration. Dynamite and the whitest sneakers award mug. Can you see that? Isn't that nice? Or maybe they should be right here. How's that? Isn't that nice? Okay, let me fix. I can fix. Don't worry. Don't trust a man.
Smart Shaddy and me.
Don't trust a midget with your belongings, okay? They cannot be trusted. So let's just fucking open this fresh and easy with a nice little clip just to get the juices flowing, because I have not got my juices flowing yet today, and I would very much like to get my juices flowing. So it's been one year since the Pine Grove Shuffle has made an appearance. And about a year ago, I would have not been podcasting because I'm a fucking idiot. Right? But if I were to have been podcasting a year ago, I would have absolutely mentioned the Pine Grove Shuffle, because I think it's one of the greatest things to ever come about on the internet. I'm not a fan of TikTok dances at all, by any means. Never have been, never will. Not a fan of dances in general. It's still kind of a trend for people to make dances for things, and I think it's It's more cheesier than cheese on poutine. Or poutine. Depends where you are in the country. If you're French, you say,
you guys got any bags of bird ham?
And if you're English, you say,
Oompa Loompa body ass bitch!
But either way, it gets the message across. But when it comes to the Pine Grove Shuffle, I fucking love it. Not only is the song good, but the dance. The dance is something special. Because it's not a dance. It's not a traditional dance that the chicks would do just to shake their booties and show off their tits. No. This is a dance by a man who has an awkward-shaped body. And he flails around expertly. And it just, you have to look at it because it's something special. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm about to show you because it's been one year since the Pine Grove Shuffle has made its fucking mark on the internet. And here is the man himself demonstrating for you and I the Pine Grove Shuffle once again. And I'm most definitely getting claimed for this, but guess what? It's worth it. It's worth it. Not like I get paid for this shit anyway, but it's worth it. My dog's doing a butt scoot all over my carpet. Yep, big shit streak on my carpet now. That's great. Thanks, Oliver. Thanks. Wow. Nothing here to care about. Isn't that nice? Let's watch it again. Now, all those on the planet who got to experience the Pine Grove Shuffle in its prime 1 year ago, we all thought, we all hoped and prayed that it was going to be the next big trend that the world would take part in. And I got to be honest, it wasn't that big. It was big, but it didn't reach... as big of an audience as some things do out there. Excuse me, I have to wipe my ass.
I don't know if I'm still in the shot.
3 weeks later.
Nothing like a good ass wipe. Am I right?
It's been...
Feeling a little off today.
Bee boo boo bop boo boo bee.
You ever just have a day where one thing after the other doesn't work for you? Oliver, stop with the butt scoots. What's your speculation, huh? You think the dog has worms? You think the dog has, Oliver, do you think the dog has, anal fluid? Huh? Is that what you think? Well, it's not, because I just got him squirted. So maybe it is worms. Or maybe he's just got shit in his ass and he wants to rub it all over the carpet. Either way, I don't give a fuck. Just kidding, I give a fuck. Alright? You think I don't care about Dodge? Alright? I really need some new fucking... Ooh, I wish if I had my phone, I could write a note. How can I do this? Oh, I know. Alexa, remind me at 7 p.m. today to make new sound bites. You couldn't hear that, but I heard it. She said, okay, I will remind you at 7 p.m. to make new sound bites. Nothing here to care about. Now, so that song is called, what is it called? I think the band is called Pine Grove. But the song itself is called Need To. N-E-E-D space number two. Need To. Nothing here to care about. And when that song came out, I was listening to Need To pretty regularly. Because the song itself is really nice. It's really peaceful. It's really relaxing. It makes you wanna do the Pine Grove Shuffle. Talk about the perfect dance for the perfect song. Am I right, guy? It doesn't get any better than that. We like crispy waffles.
It's been
Bee boo boo bop boo boo bee.
Come on, get your shit together, dude. Get your shit together. We still have yet to have an answer about UFC 303. Nothing. Okay? And to be frank about it, Ariel Helwani came out again and he said, why don't we go to X and take a read at what fucking Ariel Helwani said. What kind of name is Ariel anyway? Isn't that like the fucking name of the mermaid? It's a girl's name, guy. Ooh, meep. Oh, he had meep on. Dude, this, like, say what you want about this guy. Sure, he looks like a fucking Muppet, but Raul Rosas Jr., however you say his name, I guarantee he's going to be the next champ. He makes weird noises, too. Can we hear him do it?
One more time. Hello, Raul. How are you?
What's up, bro? Hey, before we start this interview, let's get a chihuahuas.
Oh, let's do it. Can I hear it from you?
All right, then you gotta say it.
Okay, here we go. Oh my gosh, it went so high up that the audio went out. Let's try one more time. It's going so high. It's so flipping. High pitched that I think the Zoom cancels out your audio. Is that what's happening, Frank? Okay, let's do maybe a subdued one.
All right, let me try.
Okay, I got it a little bit there. Here's my attempt. Chee-wee-wees. By the way, is it chi-wee-wees or is it chi-wee-wee?
No, chi-wee-wees.
Okay. You know, yeah, we actually have it. Frank, we have it just so we can remember. Can you play it for Raul?
Chi-wee-wees.
We have it on standby. So that was my best. What does that mean? Okay, this is good that we're starting with this. What does that mean?
Yeah, what does
it's
that
like
mean?
It's like a word of excitement, you know, like when you win or fucking or something. Instead of like saying like woo, like you're like chi-wee-wees, you know, like
came through that
like,
time.
Let's say you're with your homies and then like a girl tells you like, oh, come over, like you get excited and you're like,
you know, cutting out. That's crazy.
I love it.
But obviously that's going to be his thing forever now, right? There's been so much talk about and around that fucking chi-wee-wee thing that forever, for the rest of his career, that's going to be him. And when he becomes more popular, the whole world's going to start saying it. But yeah, it doesn't help the chi-wee-wees. It doesn't help, what's his name, Raul? It doesn't help Raul on his persona, okay? Because everyone calls him Meep Meep already, and now he's making weird noises like a Meep Meep, okay? So he's basically confirming that he is a fucking Muppet by making these noises. You little fucking Meep Meep. He's only 19 too, so like it's the beginning of his fucking career in the Yufka. He's going to fight for the title soon, and he's going to get it. And man, so for those of you who are just, Oliver, what's with the butt scoots? That's three butt scoots in a row. So for those of you who are fresh and new to the sport, and you want to experience what it's like to follow someone on the rise from literally when they start at a young age to when they become champion at an older age, and you want to follow them the whole time, now's the time, dude. Start following this Raul guy. Follow Raul. Follow Meep Meep. And you're going to see him go from somewhat of a nobody. He's starting to get a name for himself now, but he's still kind of a nobody. And you're going to see him fucking rise to the top. I guarantee it. I'm calling it right now, as is everyone else. Not like I'm saying anything out of the ordinary here, guy. But anyway, that's not why we're here. Ariel Helwani is asked what he does when he receives news off the record, but then receives the same news by someone else on the record. That's not what I care about. Bum, 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 bum. I'm trying to find the tweet he did about UFC. Oh my god, it's all Raul. Where is the tweet? Where is the tweet? Where is the tweet? Also, Raul's face is already pushed in, like, pretty far. So when he gets hit in the face, he doesn't really feel it. It doesn't hurt him because he doesn't have much of a face as is. Helwani provides an update on the time of the UFC. The pause. Aha, here we go. This is what we're looking for right here. Basically, because you remember last week when we did the update on UFC 303, Ariel said to us he is very confident and he feels very positive about the fact that Connor and Chan Chan are going to fight. But as the week went on, and he said, but he did clarify, he did say, maybe tomorrow something will change, maybe the next day something will change. It's literally been it's been a week, I guess. Exactly a week since that last post. I uploaded the episode on Saturday, or Friday or Saturday, I can't remember, hoping to have an answer, and yet we still have no answer. So hopefully by next episode we do have an answer, but here's the update we currently have right now as of June 12th at 6:08 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Ariel, take it away.
Fine. On Monday of last week, I would say the optimism level was not very high. There was some concern. There was some doubt.
That's not what you said.
There were roadblocks. I came on this show on Wednesday and said optimism was high. There was great positivity. Yeah, all those words that I used. It felt like we had dodged a bullet. It felt like we had turned a corner. On Tuesday, I reported that the UFC was sending out feelers. They were reaching out to fighters and managers to see who could possibly be available to either replace the fight, meaning two new fighters, or step in and replace one of the fighters involved to fight on this card. Obviously, the fighter that we're talking about is Conor McGregor because, if not, why would Chandler be ready to go on a plane to Dublin? And so I said that it seemed like we were all good, and by Wednesday, no feelers were being thrown out. No one was talking about this, really. It seemed as though all systems were a go. And more proof to that was Chandler doing the interview with The Pivot, speaking about everything that he had been through over the past week. That interview was done late last week. And also on the ABC card, the Fight Night card in Louisville on Saturday, on the telecast, a ton of promos regarding UFC 303 and regarding that specific fight. T-Mobile is promoting it. UFC is promoting it. All systems seem to be a go. All right. Monday, nothing really out of sort. But yesterday morning, started to hear, as I continued to check in, because I know there's a lot of anxiety, a lot of doubt, a lot of concern about this because it's such a big fight. And because no one involved, in particular from the UFC side and from the McGregor camp, are speaking about this publicly. Chandler did the one interview and that was it. And I think that squashed some concern, but no one is coming out and really talking about this. So I understand the concern. So I continue to check in and be a pest and be annoying. And I found out that via multiple sources that they are reaching out to people again. They are reaching out to managers. They are reaching out to fighters. And as I reported yesterday, as potential replacements, i.e. a new fight, as backups, as someone stepping in for McGregor, or as just insurance, as a, you know, just in case we need to know, all these things are at play. One step further. Here we are, Wednesday, 1:13. The positivity that I talked about exactly 1 week ago today is nowhere to be found. I would say this fight is very much in limbo. I would say that it's hanging on. And I would say the UFC is working very, very hard right now to figure out a plan B. Now, the plan B could be someone stepping in to fight Chandler. The plan C could be a whole new fight. If you look at the roster, if you look at who's available, if you look at the champions who have just fought or who are scheduled to fight, there aren't a ton of options. There really aren't. And we could play this exercise because, trust me, I've played it a million times. But I'm just telling you where we stand right now, and I'm telling you the God's honest truth. And you want to know why it is the truth? Go back to Dustin Poirier versus Benoit Saint-Denis. Go back to when Dustin Poirier came out and said, I'm not fighting because I wasn't happy with my deal. And then we spoke about it a little bit. Dana White was very quick to go on his social media and say that we're all a bunch of bullshitters and this isn't true. And the fight was on behind the scenes as this was all going down. They fixed it. They gave him what he wanted. This has been a story that we've talked about since Monday of last week, 10 days. That hasn't happened once. Does that not give you pause? Trust me, no one on planet Earth wants to see this fight more than me. I know everyone wants to see it just as much, but like, I am dying to see this fight. I want nothing more than to see this fight. I want to see Conor back healthy. I want to see Michael Chandler get his payday. I want to see that big fight. I want to see it for all the fans who haven't experienced a Conor McGregor fight. A new fan base has been born over the last few years. They weren't even around for DP3. They weren't even around for that in July of 2021. There is nothing like a McGregor fight. There is nothing like that scene. June, July, International Fight Week. It's magic. It's the biggest gate in UFC history, and it was that like when tickets went on sale like this. So there ain't no part of me that is hoping that this falls through, but I'll tell you as of right now, it's pessimism. They're searching for, they're reaching out, they're putting out feelers, they're making offers. This is where we stand.
All right. So the shitty thing is, it's like, you would think by now, we're literally, where's the fucking calendar? Okay, so it's the 12th today. The fight is the 29th. We're just 2 weeks out. You'd think by now, they would at least say what the fuck's going on. But they haven't said shit. It's completely silent. There's not even an inkling or a hint or a thought of what could happen. And it's like, if we get to the end of this week and there's still no announcement or there's still no actual update from Dana White about what the fuck is actually going on, it's like, what the fuck? What are we doing? Because they postponed... Oh my God, Conor McGregor just started trending right now. They postponed... I don't want to look at this yet. They postponed the what do you call it? Pre-sale of the pay-per-view. And like, what about the tickets to go to the event? Have people already bought them? And if they haven't, when are they going to become available? And if they do become available, how are you going to guarantee people are going to see who they want to see? People are going to this event because they want to see fucking Connie McGregs. But if it gets canceled and people already bought the tickets, then what? Can they get a refund? I don't fucking know. But you would think by this point there would be something said from Mr. White of the Dana himself. But nothing has been said. Now, why is Conor McGregor trending right now? It literally just became trending. Yeah, me trying to understand what... Okay, so it's nothing, really. Dude, could you imagine if the announcement came out right as I was filming this? That would be fucking awesome. Dude who spent $12,000 on Conor McGregor floor seats right now. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Dude, if you pay fucking $12,000 on fucking floor seats and you find out that fucking McGregor's isn't fucking fighting, it's like, what the hell, man? What a waste of time and money. They have to allow... They're going to have to allow fucking refunds. They'll have to. And let's say they do find someone else to take over the fight. Depending on who it is, it's going to tank. It's going to be shit. It's going to be trash. It's going to be garbage. No one's going to give a shit. Everyone's going to be pissed off that the fight that they've been wanting for the past fucking at least two years. There's been talks and talks, and maybe it was going to happen here or there and them and them. And then if we finally get the date after all this fucking around and literally the month that it's supposed to happen, we get canceled press conference in Dublin, and then it's just radio fucking silence. Like, come on, guys. I just hope to fuck this is a big tease, a big PR stunt, and they're just going to turn around and be like, joking, it was on the whole time. Because just like Ariel said, if they are actually actively looking for other people, which I guess according to Ariel's sources, they are, who the fuck are they going to get? Who the fuck are they going to get? I can't even think of anyone else who could compare. It's going to be trash. It's going to be trash. What if they don't announce anything until actually June 29th? And they'll just announce it there and be like, here's the new fight. Here's who's fighting. And then during the post-fight press conference, Dana White will be like, okay, Conor McGregor's coming back on this day. And it'll be some other fucking day in the future. You know? At least with Jake Paul, he got his fight postponed. And now he's fighting fucking Mike Perry, which, to be honest, is way more appealing. Way more fucking appealing than Mike Tyson. This is going to be fucking awesome. And it's streaming free on Netflix July 20th, the same day that the Tyson fight was supposed to happen. This is going to be fucking way better. Finally, Jake Paul is fighting a legit fucking boxer. Finally. Fine-a-fucking-ly. And he's going to get his fucking ass handed to him. I guarantee it. There's no way. Mike Perry's too fucking good. So I can't wait for that. But, by the way, Mike Tyson has been pushed ahead to November 15th. But in the meantime, since we're talking about boxing and whatnot, apparently we've got a good video right here. So why don't we give her a watch?
Put your smoke out.
What?
Wait.
Drop your smoke. Drop your smoke. Get down on the ground. Down on the ground now.
Peace for mankind. Peace for America.
Dude, I gotta quit fucking saving these videos that I haven't pre-watched. Because they come on my feed, and I'm like, oh, this is gonna be good. So I pause it, put it in my favorites folder, and then I just stop watching it. I tuck it away, and I save it for the podcast, because I'm like, this is gonna be good, all right? And guess what? It never is. It never fucking is.
It's been
bad. I mean, it was all right. It was all right. But could have been better. I was expecting a punch, maybe, because they were. It said boxing in the title right up here. When you had too much to drink and you turn into a pro boxer, at no point does he present himself as a boxer. So it's very misleading. Maybe this will be something good. I'm gonna steal that barbecue.
You're not stealing my fucking barbecue, you cocksucker. Fucking asshole. What do we all live?
Damn. Well, how long did it take him to figure out that that guy said that? Not gonna lie, this episode's trash. It's just a trash episode, but that's okay. Every now and then we have them. All right? You try doing a podcast by yourself. Go ahead. Try it. It's not as easy as it fucking looks, all right? You got to talk to yourself for an hour. All right? On the fly with nothing. With no one to bounce off of. With just a few little fucking bullet points on a piece of paper. And some fucking videos that you pre-scrambled. All right? But, you know, normally I can riffity-diffity. But today, I'm just feeling a little off. All right? You're going to get a few off episodes. But maybe it's okay. Maybe it's not as bad as I think it is. We never really know. We never really know. What's this guy's name? Michael Hunter? Hunter Biden? Hunter something? Hunter Campbell. There's a new show on Roku. Do you have Roku? If you have Roku, there's a free show, if you're a fan of UFC. It's a docuseries, basically behind the scenes of UFC. With Dana White and this guy, Hunter Campbell. Hunter Campbell's like the chief. I got the hicks. Chief legal advisor of the UFC. But he's also involved with making fights happen. He knows how to talk. He knows how to convince and he knows how to talk. So I'm sure he's involved right now with trying to find someone to replace people on UFC 303. He likes to gaslight. He likes to manipulate. But fuck, he gets the job done. I tell you what. Why don't we cut to a commercial?
After these messages, we'll be right back.
HoarDash! Oh my god, I love HoarDash. You guys know I literally don't go out to Munchbox. I always get it delivered to my house. With HoarDash, I get Asians, I get hermaphrodites, I get homeless fentanyl addicts, I get anyone and everyone from HoarDash. Sometimes I even get divorced moms because my house needs a good cleaning. I just go to HoarDash and boom, they're here in less than an hour. As an AskPass member, you can enjoy exclusive offers and perks all summer long on anal stuffers, premium lube, titty picks, and much, much more. You'll also get zero delivery fee and reduced service fees on eligible orders if you become an AskPass member. If you're looking to order now and get off or fulfill your spank bank, why don't you use HoarDash and use code Gizmo to get 50% off up to $100 value when you spend $1,500 or more. I love HoarDash and they're going to help you out. They've certainly been helping me out these past couple of months. So shop HoarDash to get everything you need for the summer. Use code GIZMO to get 50% off up to $100 value when you spend $1,500 or more at a brothel, whorehouse, or select Korean spas on HoarDash. Terms and conditions apply. All right, and we're back. since this episode is a bit drab, why don't we let this guy make you laugh a little bit? Because I certainly ain't.
Did you shit?
No, somebody did, though. It sure smells like it. They have to be close by here.
Do you need to go wipe?
Wasn't me, okay?
It was not me.
It's definitely not me. Absolutely positive. It's not me. I did not shit my pants. It's somebody else.
Okay.
I smell it too, though. N-O. Capital N-O. It's okay. Not
He's
me.
So offended.
Gotcha. You could have just started with that. I didn't hear you say
yes.
That right away.
I said it was not me.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. No worries. Okay. You have a good day.
Yeah. Okay.
Have a good one.
I like this. This is a good prank. Ooh. Stinky, stinky. Go up to him. He stinks. Please go up to him. Please go up to him.
Oh, my God. Do we need to ask Jesus to forgive your sins?
What the hell?
Sorry? Do we need to ask Jesus to forgive your sins for what you've done to this library that reeks?
Oh, man, it's over. That's a good one. I like that. The first guy was so offended. He's so pissed. He's like, no, I didn't shit. It almost makes me think maybe he did shit. Maybe he did shit his pants. I swear to God, if this becomes the clip that I post on social media, 3 fucking weeks in a row, I've done clips about shit and shitting your pants. This podcast is just turning into a fucking literal shit cast. Just every week I'm talking about shit, and I don't even mean to. It's just, that's what this is becoming. It's just becoming a poo cast. Just shit after shit after shit. But what are you going to do? There's nothing you can do. All right? The shit hawks have spoken. This is just a shit sandwich. Shit storm. We like shit around here. All right? We like mushrooms and we like shit. Just every week we're going to talk about poo. You know what? I even talked about poo with fucking that other girl. What the hell's her name? Ivy Bloom. Remember her? Man, I'm just realizing now there's too much poo. I gotta cool it with the poo. It's too much. It's too much. Okay, so let's move on. Remember, I'm pretty sure back in the day, let's see, hold on, this is fucking up on me. There we go. I'm pretty sure back in the day, I don't know when, early TikTok days, I had shown clips of some dude on TikTok who does really good impressions of Skyrim characters. Okay? Goes by the name of Jin Kid. All right. Now, if you're in the news, you're probably already aware of where I'm taking this. But if you're not aware, first, let's watch a clip of Jin Kid and his impressions of Skyrim characters.
My father once told me that if you can fix a blade, you can fix anything. Need something? Have a look. You keep your filthy hands to yourself, thief. Someone there? You keep your filthy hands to yourself, thief. Must have been the wind. Need something?
I mean, it's very good, right? It's like spot on. We loved it. I loved it. You loved it. Everyone loved it. Anyone who watched him and anyone who's any who's anyone anyone who and anyone who any anyone who's anyone who has played Skyrim knows how accurate that is. Now, for those who have not been following the news, or for those who have been living under 17 rocks, you may not be aware of the fact that this guy, the guy that you just watched, this fella right here with the bucket on his head.
Yourself, thief.
Jin Kid. Let me find a good still image. Take a good look at him. All right? Take a good, hard look into this face. You see that face? That is the face of a literal killer. He, and I'm not even like exaggerating, like he's now testifying, going to court, in court, and I think he has already been sentenced to prison for killing his ex-girlfriend and her boyfriend. There's a 4-minute clip here. I'm not going to play the whole thing, but he's in jail. There he is.
In the Superior Court of the State of California, in and for the County of San Diego, the people of the State of California, plaintiff versus Ali Nasser Abulaban, defendant, case number SCD-292181, verdict. We, the jury in the above entitled cause, find the defendant, Ali Nasser Abulaban, guilty of the crime of murder in the first degree of Rayburn Cardenas. Of Rayburn Cardenas Barong in violation of Penal Code Section 187, Parent A, as charged in count two. Oh, it is. Okay. In count two of the information. And we further find the allegation that in the commission and attempted commission of the above offense, the defendant.
Anyway, you get the point. He's in jail, killed, murdered. He shot him. Bow, bow. He took a gun and bopped him. Yeah, I said gun. I don't give a fuck. I'm not one of these people who bleep the word gun or kill or murder or suicide or rape. All right? I'm like Andrew Tate. Have you seen what Andrew Tate says on the internet now? I don't know if I can show this. I might have to blur this out. Even though I don't want to, but he's been throwing that word around a lot. You know the word, the N-word. Tate's been throwing it around like it's fucking creme de la creme. Like it's fucking pepperoni on a pizza. Or cherry on top of a cake. Like he's using the word very freely. And I don't know why. I think it's because he can. He loves to say it now. If you follow him on Twitter, he is constantly throwing that word around. Constantly. Almost every second tweet, he's throwing the N-word in. And don't know why. Well, I do know why, because it's Tate. Because he can, that's why. We're going to cut this episode short. I got one more clip, and then I've got a Joshua Block update, because fuck me. I'm not feeling it today. And that's okay. That is okay. Not every episode is a bop. But this guy is.
We're here with Snodi. What's your talent?
Snodi?
Multiplexy talented, you know, but I have this one song, you know, called Wagwan Delilah. You want to hear it?
Let me hear that.
Wagwan Delilah, what's she like in Toronto City? I'm 2,000 kilometers away, but girl, tonight you look so bad. Oh, yes, you do. Don't that spray don't shine as bright as you. Top left, top left. Yo, why are you looking at me like that, fam?
This video has been stuck in my head for the past several days. I can't stop thinking about it. I think it's fantastic. Snowdier? It's a Toronto accent. No, you know, not really. I mean, no one actually talks like that. It's the exaggerated form of the Toronto accent. But this guy is playing a character, and he does a really good job. And he's got this new song, and he's putting... It's just a whole thing. Go check out Snowdier. Snowdier? On the talk. You won't regret it. All right? If that was a legit person, you'd find it cringe, but he's not a legit person. He's playing a character, and it's fucking funny. What's this?
Tell you that's not Earth, right?
Oh, is this a real show, or is this a fake show? Don't know. Don't care. Here's our update on Joshua Blog. I don't actually know when this happened. This might have happened in February, which I think it did, but regardless, it's something that happened, because we need an update every episode now. It's just part of the thing. It's part of the Dynamite Gizmo podcast.
Some asshole in Times Square stole my wallet. Now I have to cancel my credit and debit card now. Like, what am I supposed to do? It takes 7 to 10 business days to mail a new card. I'm financially frozen right now.
It kind of sounds like he's actually frozen, to be honest, when he talks, because of how slow he is. I'm financially frozen right now. Wagwan Delilah. I want to learn how to do that accent. I can do the snow day, but that's about it. Yeah, this episode sucks. God, it really... This episode blows, dude. Yeah. And the crazy thing is when you go into the episodes thinking they're going to be all right, those are the ones that are trash. It's weird how that works. And then the ones that you are like, I don't know about today, those are the ones that are always good. Always. It's just how it works. If I could find, you know, you would think by episode 203, I would find some sort of rhythm, some sort of format that works in order to curate topics better, but I still have yet to. I still freeball it every time. And I think it's because I didn't have, if you actually could read, but... I won't show you on here because it's tradition around here to show you the card but not show you what's on the card. But you'll find out anyway because we'll talk about it. If I actually wrote proper topics on here and actually sat down throughout the week and came up with better things to talk about, like I did in the beginning or in the middle or whenever, then it would be better. So maybe from now on I'll just prepare a little better. That's all it takes, is just preparation. I mean, it's not that fucking hard, guy. All right. I also forgot to mention I might be doing... Well, I'm not even going to mention it. I might start doing essay videos more. But those come out... Like, are they going to come out very rare? Because I'm going to work really hard on them. I'm going to spend a lot of time on them. The podcast is a weekly commitment. My streaming is somewhat of a weekly commitment. The podcast is number one commitment. But then the video essays that I'm going to do are going to be maybe once a month, once every 2 months. Who knows? But I'm going to try it because I think I can really accomplish something with those. And also check out my stream. Like, follow me. You're going to want to hit the bell because I stream every now and then. I've been playing Super Mario 64, and it's actually really fun. And I think that is what I'm going to do instead of God of War for now. Anyway. That's it for this episode of the Dynamite Gizmo podcast, episode 203. Maybe next episode will be a bit better. Don't judge every episode. Some are bad, some are good. Please like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell if you want. You don't have to. But yeah, That's it. Bye. I'm so hungry, just like every episode, so I'm going to eat. Bye.